A news coming in from Parliament is that the Public Accounts Committee, together with the Local Government Accounts Committee, have started to investigate the COVID relief cash that was sent out recently to Ugandans. Their major concern is that while some people got 100,000, others got 200,000 shillings at a go. And now they want Prime Minister Robin Nabanja to explain this anomaly. We have this report.
The Joint Committee of Public Accounts Committee and the Local Government Public Accounts Committee of Parliament has today embarked on the probe to scrutinize the list of beneficiaries. The probe was sanctioned by the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Amnita Mongin, to establish where the said beneficiaries actually received the money.
In accordance with the terms of reference given to us by Parliament, to find out, one, that the whether or not the intended beneficiaries actually benefited from the relief. Number two, the policy behind the decision to give relief to particular groups and not others. We want to study that. We also want to study whether all intended beneficiaries received the relief or not.
When you look at the policy framework that guided the process, definitely we'll be engaging the ministries responsible, all right? Be it Minister of Gender, be it Minister of Finance, be it the Office of the Prime Minister, local government. So we will be looking at that. But also we will be interacting with the entities that were charged with the responsibility of compiling the list, identifying the beneficiaries.
The Joint Committee is set to summon all relevant agencies which were involved in the controversial project, including the telecom companies that dispersed the money to beneficiaries.
We are also going to look at the methods of disbursement, how these monies reach the intended beneficiaries. So if the money went through a particular telecommunication company or through a network, you know, a mobile money service, we will then have to engage them and get to understand. All right. First, to know from government how they arrive at choosing those telecommunication companies, but also how the telecommunication companies manage the process.
Loopholes within the system that we want to find out, and what exactly happened after, because these are two issues. You finding out that there is someone who registered his number, and the numbers are not in his names. What did you do?
The PAC chairperson, Menard Seguna, says they're going to dig deep into allegations of people who received their 100K tries to establish whether there was fraud.
Those who received the tries will also know why and how do you remedy, because that money was intended to go to certain people. Why did it not go there, and why did it go to the wrong address twice or to the right address twice? Somebody would have received it once, received it twice. Somebody will have to give us the explanation.
Of recent, we saw the minister was on the TVs, and he said that about 6,000 people, they were given double payment. We want to go into that and analyze them.
The committee is to traverse the country to sample the lists of beneficiaries to establish credibility and integrity of the process and also the variability of the beneficiaries.
We need to call them and physically meet them, because the committee is going to traverse the whole country, especially in those cities and the municipalities, to meet those people physically. They come with their national identification cards and their phone, and we call them to get to know whether they are the real people who got the money.
We shall do what we are supposed to. Ugandans should not expect a lot from us, but they should know that we are doing accountability of their monies, the monies you are supposed to receive, of which the majority never received, and we're trying to see how we can correct some errors which were done by some of these government officials, such that they may not reoccur in the future.
Today, the committee sat and agreed on the methodology to be applied in this probe. The Minister of Gender collected data from 501,107 vulnerable poor people, and 87,503 did not pass the verification exercise.